Given the cost function c of x, we want to determine a, what is the cost at the production level of 1,700, b, what is the average cost at the same production level, c, what is the marginal cost at the same production level, d, what is the production level that will minimize the average cost, and e, what is the minimum average cost. So to determine the total cost at the production level of 1,700, we want to find c of 1,700. So we'd have 16 times the square root of 1,700 plus 1,700 squared divided by 15,625. And now we'll go to the calculator and round this to the nearest cent. I've already entered this in, so if we press enter, to the nearest cent, this would be $844.66. So the total cost at this production level is $844.66. Next, we're asked to find the average cost at the same production level, where the average cost function is equal to the cost function divided by the production level, or the total cost divided by the production level. So we could just take the value of A and divide by 1,700, but I do want to go through how we find the average cost function because we'll need this later. Now instead of dividing by x, we will multiply by 1 over x instead, which is equivalent. So we'd have 1 over x times the total cost function, which is 16 times square root x, which I'm going to write as 16x to the 1/2, and then plus x squared divided by 15,625. When we find this first product, the result would be 16 divided by x to the 1/2. What's happening here is we have x to the 1/2 in the numerator, and we have x to the first in the denominator. So when we subtract, we have x to the power of 1/2 minus 1, which is x to the power of negative 1/2, leaving us with x to the 1/2 in the denominator. And then for the second product, notice how one factor of x simplifies out, leaving us with plus x divided by 15,625. So this is the average cost function. So to find the average cost function at the production level of 1,700, we'll evaluate this function at x equals 1,700. Of course, this to the 1/2 power is the same as the square root of 1,700. And now we'll go back to the calculator. And just notice how here I use the square root of 1,700 instead of 1,700 to the 1/2 power, which is equivalent. If we round to the nearest cent, notice how the 6 in the third decimal place indicates the round up, so this would round to 0.50, or 50 cents. So the average cost per item at this production level is 50 cents per item. Part C, what is the marginal cost at the production level of 1,700? The marginal cost function is the derivative of the total cost function, and this is often used to approximate the cost of the x plus 1th item, or in this case, the cost to make the 107 1st item. To find the derivative of this cost function, let's go ahead and write this as c of x equals 16x to the power of 1/2 plus x squared divided by 15,625. Notice in this form, we can apply the power rule of differentiation. So the marginal cost function, or c prime of x, would be equal to, multiply by 1/2, that's 8, subtract 1 from the exponent, that would be x to the power of negative 1/2. The derivative of x squared would be 2x, so we'd have plus 2x divided by 15,625. And now we'll evaluate the derivative function at x equals 1,700. We can write this first term as 8 divided by 1,700 to the positive 1/2 power if we want, plus 2 times 1,700 divided by 15,625. And again, back to the calculator. And notice this time I did use the rational exponent in the denominator rather than the square root. Rounding to the nearest cent or two decimal places, this would be approximately 0.41, which means the marginal cost at this production level is 41 cents. Which again means when the production level is 1,700, it'll cost approximately 41 cents to make the next item. For part D, we want to determine what the production level will, what is the production level that will minimize the average cost? Well, here's the average cost function from part B, which we see here. So if we want to minimize this function, the first step is to find the critical numbers, and there are two ways to do this. We can find where the derivative function is equal to zero or undefined, or when the average cost and marginal cost are equal. We'll go ahead and find the critical numbers using part A. So before we find the derivative of this function though, let's rewrite this so that this is 16x to the power of negative 1/2. So we can apply the basic power rule of differentiation. So the derivative of the average cost function would be equal to, here we'll multiply by negative 1/2, that'd be negative 8, subtract 1 from the exponent, that would be x to the power of negative 3/2, and the derivative of x is 1, so we have plus 1 divided by 15,625. So this is equivalent to negative 8 divided by x to the power of 3/2 plus the fraction. Well, notice when x equals 0, the derivative function is undefined, but when x equals 0, the production level is 0, so we're not going to use this as a critical number, so now we'll set this equal to 0 and solve for x. Let's go ahead and add this fraction here to both sides, which would give us 1 over 15,625 equals 8 divided by x to the power of 3/2. This is a proportion, so now let's go ahead and cross multiply and then solve for x. So 1 times x to the 3/2 equals 8 times 15,625. So that would give us x to the 3/2 equals 125,000. Now because we want x to the first, we're going to raise both sides of the equation to the reciprocal power of 3/2, which would be 2/3. Here we multiply the exponents, giving us x to the first, or just x. To evaluate the right side, we'll go back to the calculator. 125,000 raised to the power of 2/3. We do need this exponent in parentheses. That gives us 2,500. So this is the only feasible critical number, but we are trying to minimize this function. To verify the function is actually minimized at this value though, we should use either the first or second derivative test to determine whether this value minimizes or maximizes the function. Let's go ahead and use the second derivative test so we can determine whether the function is concave up or concave down at this x value. So here's our first derivative function. So the second derivative function would be equal to, here we're going to multiply by negative 3/2. Well, negative 8 times negative 3/2 is positive 12. Subtract 1 from the exponent, that would be x to the power of negative 5/2. The derivative of the fraction is 0. So this is equivalent to 12 divided by x to the power of 5/2. And notice that when x is equal to 2,500, this would be positive, greater than 0, which indicates the function is concave up at this x value, which is good news because that means we have a relative minimum function value at x equals 2,500. So we can say the average cost is minimized at the production level of 2,500 units. And then finally for part D, we're asked to determine the minimum average cost. And again, here's the average cost function. We just determined that the average cost function here is minimized when x equals 2,500. So we'll evaluate the average cost function at x equals 2,500. This gives us 0.48, or 48 cents. So the minimum average cost per item would be 48 cents. I hope you found this helpful.